Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to explain how to play Alliance Conquest as well as what type of leads and team ups can do higher performance and also what are the mistakes we are doing generally. Let's have a look on it. This is the current rank of our Alliance in this AZ. We almost won easily. Now have a look on it in our opponents. Sahil Styles 960. Stifle lead is really good for Doctor Strange tier 3 as well as DP tier 3. He can perform really well with a debuff removal lead. It was same as Angel lead to Corvus Glaivius and Spider-Man 2099 is really good. Odin lead for Dormammu and Hulk as a villain is really good, and Doctor Strange lead for Iron Man and Spider-Man is not good, and also DP lead for Apocalypse and Cable is not good. DP lead only for self, it won't give support to any of his allies, so it's totally useless. And also using two buff team buffs like Time Freeze and Spider-Man in a single team is totally useless. He should use in another team to give more tough to the opponents. Then Odin lead for Scarlet Witch is really very very good, and also BRB lead for Thor and Einhammer is really very very good, and also Luke Cage lead for physical attack toons is really good. And also one more guy gave BRB lead for Thor and also Nebula also having lightning damage, so it's really very very good. Then these teams are really very good. They planned very perfect, almost gave debuff removal team. It's really hard to kill, I think. Then Captain America Hydra lead for Hulk tier 3 is really good, which gives 30% increase HP lead, plus Valkyria support gives 30% HP as from passive, so it's really very good. Then physical attack lead, 30% physical attack lead for Black Panther is really good. Then it's totally useless for Spider-Man. Medusa lead only buffs for universal type, it won't give buff to Spider-Man, you have to change that. Then base 3, now we will move to base 3. Here Spider-Man 2099 lead is really very good, 50% ignore dots, but he used 3 Spider-Mans, it's really very very useless. Opponent can easily clear this team by using debuff removal lead. He should separate the Spider-Mans into different bases to perform higher, and also he should use blue Marvel lead for more survival. Anti-Man lead is really good, but for more survival he should use blue Marvel lead here, and also here the lead is not good, I forget the name really. Then he should use Rogue lead instead of Colossus, because Colossus lead only good against a physical attack. Rogue lead gives 36% of all defense, which is really very very good. Then SR lead is not good here. He should give all attack or energy attack or all defense or energy attack lead must for this team. Totally this team is totally sucks. There is no team up or anything here. Then here the 30% HP use only for villains, not for Storm or this guy don't deserve that. Then here it's really very good, both Scarlet Witch as well as Star-Lord gives energy attack buff for that will be good. Then Magneto lead, Cyclops support for Professor X really good. The damage will be insane. And then ma'am, Jean lead with Apocalypse and also Colossus support is really a deadly combo. You can't remove this team easily. Then again, good team lead. Then it's totally again a mistake. You should give Iron Hammer lead for Thor, because Iron Hammer gives some 15% of lightning damage as well as 15% of energy attack that buffs. Thor's lead gives some lightning resist, that's totally useless. Here Captain Marvel lead for Black Widow is not good. Black Widow does physical attack, but Captain Marvel gives energy attack lead, it's totally useless. And also here Mr. Fantastic gives 65% of all attack for his allies. He used something different here. Beast lead to Mr. Fantastic and also Black Bolt. Black Bolt does energy attack here, it's totally useless. And also here he should use Cyclops or Thanos lead here, that will be buff for two teams. But he used Spider-Man, Scarlet Spidey, that's totally useless. That buff also won't work for both Cyclops as well as Thanos, that's useless. Here also the team is totally useless. And now base 4, nice lead for both the teams. BRB and Ronan lead is really very very good. Then Ant-Man will perform really good with Malekith lead. Then energy attack lead for Professor X is really very very good. Cable lead is really good, which gives 50% of ignore dodge. Then I don't know why he gave 30% of lightning damage to Red Skull and Invincible Woman. Both are not in Red Skull doing energy attack and Invincible Woman doing mind damage like the energy attack, but it's totally useless. Then Medusa lead for CG as well as Proxima is good. Here this team is really hard to outtake. Doctor Strange lead with the support of Iron Man as well as Wasp is really hard to kill. Then Magneto lead for Wolverine as well as Rogue is really good. Then here is a badass team. Jean Grey lead with Thanos and as well as Colossus support. It's really a deadly combo. Then one more deadly combos. Silver Surfer lead with Black Widow and also gives 30% increase HP from passive skill of Valkyrie. Then Blue Marvel lead for Nova is really very very good. Both will do high damage as well as high survival. And also Angel lead for Scarlet Witch as well as Cap is really very good. Then energy attack lead for Cyclops as well as Enchantress is good, but the buff is not work for both Cyclops as well as Enchantress, so it's useless I think. Then Supergiant lead for QS and Hulk is really very good. Then the second team up is Squad 2 is really very very good. It gives 65% all attack as well as some passive skill buff from Thing is really very good. Now here is really very good team. Sentinel lead for Azar and Spider-Man is really good. Now we look for Area 7. Thanos lead only buffs for super villains, but he gave 2 buffs for Thanos. I don't think it will be a good thing. Then Ronan Flavel as well as Singularity is really good. This team is totally buff, but easily we can wipe out using debuff removal team. They don't use this type of total buff teams like Cyclops, 30% energy attack buff, Star-Lord, 55% of energy attack with Doctor Strange is totally useless. We can easily wipe out, I think. Then physical attack lead for Spider-Man is good. Better you should give debuff removal team for Spideys. Then 36% of all defense for Scarlet, sorry, Sharon Rogers as well as Black Panther is really very good, very very good. Then the squad 2 is not good. You should give at least Mr. Fant lead. No one will get buff from this lead. Then the other teams are not good, and also poor buffs and leads. Here Namor lead gives 25% of critical rate. I think it will be good with Strom, because Strom passive gives 30% of like elemental buffs. That's good. Then here a blue marble lead for universal toons like Medusa and Nova is really very very good. Now we are going for area 5, Dead of Dead Man. He gives Scarlet Silver Surfer with Destroyer as well as Nova. I don't think it will be very useful. Both Silver Surfer and Destroyer in the same team is totally useless. You should give Destroyer and another team and also strong defense to Scarlet Witch, sorry, Silver Surfer, and also the squad 2 is really good. Then Seagull Clade is not good in AC, because Seagull Clade only good against male opponents. If opponents used female, that totally useless. And also he used Silver Surfer as a team member. He should use Silver Surfer as a lead, not as a team member. Then here RNG, he used a big mistake here. He should use universal support for universals. He should use universal teams only while using Flavel. Flavel supports only for universal teams, not for Doctor Strange. Whenever you use Doctor Strange, use debuff removal lead like Jean, Angel, Silver Surfer, Doom, like that. That will be good. Here Namor lead is not good. Namor gives only 25% of critical rate. Give him all attack or all defense lead for this team. Then it was a great team, both squad 1 as well as squad 2. Jean lead with Thanos and also Colossus, and also BRB with Thor and also Hydra Cap. Hydra Cap won't get buff from BRB, but it's good. Then one more good team from Kirti, Silver Surfer lead with Thanos and also Colossus, and the squad 2 also having major buff, debuff as well as a big team. Jean lead with Apocalypse support with Black Widow. It's highly unkillable. Then it's a poor team up, like Doctor Strange lead to QS is not totally worthy. He should give debuff lead. He should replace QS instead of Odin as a lead. Then it will be a good team. And also using Doctor Strange as well as Professor X in the same team is not, I don't think it will be work much, because Doctor Strange does mind control, and also Doctor Strange doing some time doing some time freeze. Opponents can be easily wipe out this team by using our time Doctor Strange with the debuff lead, so it's totally useless. Then team 2 is good, really good. Then Wasp lead for Hulk is really very good. Angel for Wolverine is really good. Then here it's Darren did very very good. Thanos lead for Apocalypse and CG is really very good, deadly combo. And also Squad 2 is also very good, perfect team up. Then here finally RNG gave some decent and also a perfect team. SS lead for Thanos and also Colossus support. It's really very hard to take out, so that's the reason Area 5 is still under our control. Then it's I don't think why he did like this. Captain Hydra lead for Black Widow and also Destroyer. It's totally different type of attack. Sri Krishna, he dumped all the tier 3s in a single place, but there is no use. I think he should use at least Bucky lead for this team, squad 1, and also squad 2 is little better. He should use debuff lead for Doctor Strange, I think. Then area 6 full of dump characters. I don't think we should review this. The only good thing is Artana with for fire damage lead is really good. Then as usual, Doctor Strange with the debuff lead is good. And then other here squad 1 full of physical reflectors in the same place. I think opponent used some physical attacks teams like that. I think here all the teams are looked decent but not good. Joe's used a poor team up here. I think he is in Haribari. He just selected Luna and went to team bonus strike. I think it's give him a use Luna separate and SRS separate like that. Then Whale Gamer also in Haribari. I think he used Doctor Strange and also Scarlet Spidey in the same team. I don't think why he used it like this. And also he used a perfect team, SS with Hulk support. Sorry, Hulk for Hulk SS lead is really very good. Both will do so a different attack, and also opponent can't use perfect team for this. And then Joe's again, 30% HP for HP lead for Hulk is really good. Dormammu, and also he did make big mistake in squad 2. DP lead only for self, not for allies. You have to remember that. Then Area 11, not a big team up. I think it was taken on day 1, so all are used poor teams here. Then Area 8, here also not a big buffs teams, and also not a big deal here. The only good team is here is Silver Surfer lead with Colossus support and also Flavel support. Here Dormammu lead is a big joke here. Then debuff lead for Ant-Man as well as this guy is really very good. Here Odin lead for BRB and Thor is really good. Then HP lead for Hulk is really good. Some good teams also here. Then Area 12, the only orange captured area. It looks decent and also good. Used proper team ups. It's literally hard to take out, I think. They did really good except this team. Wolverine lead for DP and Sabretooth is poor lead up. Then others are really good, and also BP lead for Storm is not good. Then other leads and buffs are really very very good. I think you will get some ideas from this video. Hope you will get some knowledge from this video. Make sure that you guys subscribed and don't forget to like this video, guys.
மறக்காம சர்ப்ரைஸ் பண்ணுங்க.